Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to name ethers. So there's two ways to name ethers, and we'll look at both of them. So I'm going to start, and I'm going to number each side. My longest chain is three carbons, so that'd be a prop. And my shorter chain over here is two carbons, so that would be eth as my prefix there. So I'm going to show you first the IUPAC way to name them, but ethers are actually more commonly referred to by their common names. So the IUPAC way to name this is to refer to the shorter chain and the oxygen as a substituent coming off of a parent chain. So if it was just one, two carbons, it'd be an ethyl group. Because there's the oxygen there, it's an ethoxy group. And that is at the one position on that longest propyl chain. So this would be a 1-ethoxypropane. So this part here is my substituent. The other way that you see ethers named is through what we'd call the common name. And the common name system is to have an alkyl ether. So alkyl is the group on one side, the other alkyl is the group on the other side, and then it is an ether as a functional group. We do this in alphabetical order, so I've got an ethyl on the left-hand side and a propyl on the right-hand side. So this would be, as the common name, an ethyl, and then there's a space, propyl, space, ether. So here's a more complicated ether. The substituents have substituents, so you have two chains that are asymmetrical on either side. The longest chain would be the one on the right-hand side, so you'd have four carbons, so bute would be your prefix for your parent name. So you always start numbering adjacent to the oxygen. So on the right-hand side, I've got my bute. On the left-hand side, I've got a prop here. So if I wanted to name it with the IUPAC name, you're going to see it gets kind of confusing because this whole thing is a substituent, and on your substituent is a substituent. So that is a 2-chloropropoxy. That thing is a substituent, and that is at the one position on the whole molecule. So you're going to have to, what you can do is you can put brackets around it when you add it as a substituent. The other substituent is a bromo group, and B comes before the C in the alphabet, and so this would be first alphabetically. So you would have 3-bromo, and then here's where you use your parentheses, and then at the one position on the main chain is a 2-chloropropoxy, and then you've got your main chain, which is a butane. So the IUPAC name for that is 3-bromo-1,2-chloropropoxybutane. Alternatively, you can name it as an alkyl-alkyl ether using the common name. So again, we still number from the oxygen, from the carbon adjacent to the oxygen. So this side over here would be a 2-chloropropyl, and this side over here would be a 3-bromobutyl. So you have a propyl and a butyl chain coming off either side of the ether, and they each have a substituent on them. So you put the substituent in front of the propyl or the butyl, and then the locant for where it is on that substituent. This would go in alphabetical order, so the 3-bromo would come first. So the common name would be 3-bromobutyl, and then a space, 2-chloropropyl, and then a space, and then ether. So that would be the common name for this molecule. Lastly, if you have a symmetrical ether, so the alkyl group on either side is the same, we just put one alkyl group name out in front, and then we know that the same alkyl group is on either side. We know it's symmetrical. So this top one would be called ethyl ether, and this bottom molecule here would be called propyl ether, just as an example. So you don't have to put ethyl ethyl ether or propyl propyl ether. If there's only one alkyl group named out in front, we would assume that it was a symmetrical ether, and we could just call it as such. So this has been a look at how to name ethers. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks!